This is Ham Radio Now, episode 218. TAPR Digital Communications Conference Preview. I'm Gary Pierce, KN4AQ. I'm going to talk to Steve Bible in a moment, and we'll dial him up on the Skype line. First, I am at the beach. Here, look at this. That's where I am, in this beach house, and that's my view looking out there at the beach. I'm just a silhouette over here. You can't really see me because I've got the camera all stopped down so that you can see outside. And now I'm going to turn all that off and close the window so that I can see my monitors, because I can't see anything here. I'm totally blinded by it. So let me do that. We'll be right back. Okay, so yeah, I know the view isn't nearly as pretty, and I'm missing the beach stuff, but I can see the monitors. And speaking of seeing the monitors, joining me here on those monitors is Steve Bible, N7HPR, from the TAPR Digital, TAPR Tucson, TAPR. I'm getting it confused here, Steve. Help me
out. You're gonna have to do that one over again. Just say TAPR. We just don't really say Tucson anymore.
No more Tucson.
No.
So anyway, one of the deals is here, you can't see it anymore. I am near sand and ocean. You are near sand. No
and
ocean.
And cactus.
No ocean. You're in Phoenix, right?
Yes.
Okay. So what I want to do here is go over the digital communications conference stuff. Let me just show the web page for it. It's the wrong picture. There we go. And I'm in a compromised location for internet bandwidth.
Losing bandwidth.
Yeah. So you'll just deal with it as best we can.
Okay.
Here's, oh, yeah. It's Skype is yelling at us. So here's the TAPR website, the Digital Communications Conference. This is the conference thing itself. And it's coming up in October, 9th through 11th. And, it says 2014 here, Steve.
Uh-oh.
Have I got the right one?
You've got the right one. That's a cut and paste error. So I'll get that fixed, but don't let anybody throw that. You'll notice that it says it was revised in 2015.
Yeah.
So this is the most current one.
So you're working your way back to, you're still fixing the one from last year.
Well, of course, take from last year and we bring it up forward. So there's your proverbial cut and paste error.
Yep. So what I want to do is just go over quickly what the what's going to be coming up. Now, it's in a week and a half. It's probably too late for anybody to sign up to come to it for this year. But I suppose if you hurry, it's in the Chicago suburbs, Arlington Heights.
Well, if you can make it, definitely go up to the DCC website and register for the conference.
Yeah.
The conference hotel rate, however, is expired. And I also understand that the hotel is booked up full. So there is a Marriott property right across the street. And I believe we advertise which one it is if you look on the DCC website. So there is a hotel nearby. And no, we would love to have you. You can even be a walk-in for that matter. Just come in, walk in, pay your fee, and come in and enjoy the DCC.
Yeah, so maybe tough for people who would be traveling from long distance out of town, get a book a late flight, and you're going to pay the exorbitant airline. But it's driving distance from several hundred miles around Chicago, easy. And there's a few hams in Chicago, my hometown. So, maybe you guys can come out. One of the things I remember from previous DCCs, I think it happened in Chicago, is people came out expecting a $15 ham fest or a $9 ham fest. And that's not what it is.
No, this is a technical conference where we do a call for papers. This year we got about 16 plus papers, and it's published in a proceedings, which you get a copy of the proceedings while attending, or you can order the proceedings from the ARRL. And we invite the writers to come and present their papers, of which there's 12 plus of those coming. And they, if you take a look at the schedule that's on page 2 of the PDF there, the schedule, and look at the talks that have all but three or four of those talks are the papers that are submitted, and those are the authors presenting their papers.
Okay, we'll take a look at those in a second. What I was getting at is it's not a $9 ham fest. And some people came out, there are some introductory sessions on Saturday for some things. We'll take a look at those, but it's more expensive than that. If for a single day, it's like $75 for the whole.
Yeah, and of course, we're past the early bird prices as well, but we don't want to focus on the cost. We want to focus on the value here.
I understand, but I just don't want anybody to be super disappointed to come out to this and say, whoa, that's way more expensive than I thought it would be.
And it may be if you're used to going to a ham fest, it's $5 or $10. And of course, a ham fest, you get a variety of things depending upon if there's a tailgating or talks or otherwise. What the fees pay for is the hotel and the food. There is no profit made from this conference. All the monies that we take in, this is a break-even affair.
Yeah, I'm not trying to beat you up on the money. What I'm doing is warning the people who would be interested in coming or think they might be interested that it is a serious technical conference, first of all. So you're going to be seeing pretty high-end technical stuff. And it is not a $9 ham fest. It's going to be somewhere between $75 and a couple hundred dollars if you want the banquets and all the meals and stuff included. So, it's serious business. But if you live in the Chicago area, in driving distance or anywhere, and if you want to pay the big airplane rates for getting out there late, you can still get there. So that's taken care of. Let's take a look at the venue. Let's see. Here's the hotel. So you have real nice facilities. It's in a nice hotel ballroom. Air conditioned, beautiful, lots of audiovisual support. You're breaking up a little bit. You're saying free Wi-Fi? Okay. Yeah, Skype is...
free Wi-Fi for the conference, which is... Oh, yeah, no, we've got everything taken care of. Oh, yeah, free Wi-Fi. We got to make sure that... Well, of course, you pay for that. You know, that's part of the fees, but at least you have that, so...
Yeah. Free is.
Are you hearing the neighbor there on the phone?
I can hear your neighbor, but we'll deal with it.
Okay.
So back to the conference itself. I was going to try to pin you down on a few of the specific topics and have you pick some favorites. And I think you were saying that you couldn't do that.
No, are all really good topics. I hope that the people that are coming to the DCC can take a look at the schedule, look at the topics here. And these are all fantastic topics. These are leading edge projects that are going on in amateur radio today.
Okay. And there's a few. I mean, there's plenty of acronyms and things that don't make a lot of sense unless you've already been in the middle of them. For example, what the heck is TAS?
Okay, so that's the totally awesome. that's what the TA stands for, totally awesome. But it's a timing device that John Ackerman has released, and of course he'll be talking about it there. But you're right. I usually do my best to put as few abbreviations on there and try to spell things out, and that one escaped us.
Okay, so. These are the introductory sessions. There's three of them. Digital Voice Standards, John Hayes. Free DV with the SM1000, which is that speaker mic thing that will do digital voice. And I still haven't hooked up. I bought it, but I haven't hooked it up yet. Mm-hmm. And then a system update for Fusion and Wires X. This is the Yaesu system with Chris Wilson in 0CSW. So he's going to be... hopefully revealing some new information about the Wires X deal, because there's been some issues about that not connecting to the internet for repeaters, at least not yet. So maybe he'll have something to reveal.
Well, we hope so. Well, what we do is on Saturday, there's the main session, the introductory session. What we want to do is have something for everyone. We don't want to have people feel that, you know, it's a super high over your head technical conference and there's nothing for me there. And that's We do believe there is something for everyone that's there. And the big thing, too, is to come out and socialize and get to meet everyone.
And so for the for the introductory sessions, it's still it's all one day. It's all Saturday, but there's a one day relatively expensive one day fee. It's still like $75 or $100 or something like that for a single day.
When you go on there to register, you can either register for one day, a la carte, or you can register for the 2 day.
Yeah, so it's still not going to be a $9 ham fest with a couple of forums. It's still. Make sure you know what you're getting into. That's all I'm saying.
Well, what you're getting yourself into is a really great time being on the cutting edge of technology, hearing people give presentations about their papers that they've submitted that are being published in the proceedings, and get a chance to mingle and get ideas.
Which is the big deal of going to the conference.
Absolutely.
We're going to talk about doing video in a moment, but first I want to look at this little spot over here on the right, this 3D modeling for amateur radio. Stephen Bible, N7HPR, is going to be presenting that, and that is the Sunday seminar, and that is a pretty big deal because it's 4 hours worth. You got 4 hours to talk about this thing?
Well, and of course, it's 4 hours. It's a deep dive. It allows people to wrap their head around it, so to speak, ask a lot of questions. And we always work on a Sunday seminar, which is a 4 hour time slot. Of course, we have a break in there and about a half hour or so. So it allows you to learn a new technology and take that home and use it yourself.
So tell me a little bit about this 3D modeling. What is it you're going to be teaching people?
Okay, so there's a plethora of 3D modeling software that's available today, and there is free versions, which is the one that I'm going to teach is the 123D from Autodesk, and I'm also going to demonstrate the Autodesk Inventor, which is a paid-for version, and show you what each one can do and what their capabilities are. If you've sketched projects on the back of a napkin, what this is going to do is show you how to take that sketch and put it into a 3D model.
I think you got to my next question, which was, what do you actually do with this? Is that for laying out a circuit board or for building a case, or what does the 3D model do for you?
Well, it allows you to visualize, you know, the full volume, three dimensions of that thing that you're making. Now, it can be a printed circuit board, but what I'm going to do is I'm going to use an example of building an enclosure for a Raspberry Pi. So there's a lot of these single board computers that hams are using today. The Raspberry Pi is one that's really popular. So I chose it because I can download the dimensions for it, and I can show how you can model an enclosure for it. Now, how do you get that built? Either you can build it yourself on a milling machine, or you can print it out on a 3D printer, or you can send it to a service bureau like Shapeways and have them make it out of whatever material you choose. And I'll be talking about that as well during the Sunday seminar.
Okay, so preempted my next question, was if it had anything to do with a 3D printer, which it sort of does. So the next thing I see down here is this dinner and the banquet speaker, Ward Silver N0AX. Tell me a little bit about what that's all about.
Okay, Ward Silver is going to be attending the DCC. And of course, Ward is the editor of the ARRL handbook. He's also going to be our ARRL representative for the conference, and he's graciously accepted our invitation to be our banquet speaker. And as you can see by the title there, he's going to be talking about what ham radio is and what's coming here in the future.
Yeah,
least I think that's what it sounds like. Well, by the title.
Radio, yeah, ham radio, now what? I guess that kind of be a little bit open-ended, but it's something that I've been really interested here on Ham Radio Now. And when you introduced the speaker at the Dayton banquet, Michael Osman, the HackRF guy, you danced around that subject to some extent in talking about how the folks in the audience, which were mostly, you know, us old gray hairs, except even though my hair should be gray, it's not yet, all started in our teens. And there we were sitting in that room, all in our 50s, 60s, some in our 70s. And where do we get the young people? So I got a feeling that Ward is going to touch on that to some extent. But who knows? We'll see.
Yeah, we'll see.
Yep.
The folks you gotta attend.
The folks who come to the DCC, they don't decide to go based on looking over the list of presentations that are going to be made. They've made, before this list is out, most of the people who are coming have made the decision to go, I would think.
Well, we do definitely have our repeat visitors because they know that they're going to be hearing, you know, they're there because they want to hear what's new. And they know that they're going to hear and see and speak and ask questions and rub shoulders with the people who are working on leading edge. So that is their main impetus for being there. And of course, the schedule shows the titles of the exact what is new.
All right. So my news is that even though, let me dial this up here, even though this Kickstarter didn't make it this year, which is was the third year for the Kickstarter and the first time that it didn't work, I'd asked for $10,000. We came to about 6,400 and didn't get any of the corporate backers that I was. No, I take it back. There were a couple of folks in there that were at the corporate level, but we didn't even come close. And then I tried this rather pathetic attempt at a Patreon thing. Now, first of all, I got 41 Patreon subscribers at $303 a month, which is very nice. I really appreciate that. But I tried for this milestone goal to come out to the TAPR conference. If we got up to $2,000 a month, and as you can see, we're not anywhere near $2,000 a month. So I've decided to come anyway.
Well, we appreciate that.
I can't not do this. This is way too important to me and everything else. So I guess what I'm going to do is just kind of hope that the community who would support it at whatever the level they can will continue to do that. And
absolutely. And we'll continue to promote it as well, because everybody does value what you're doing and everybody appreciates you, Gary.
Yeah. So in a week and a half, you get to go out and see everything all at once. And then online, if you can't make it from Ham Radio Now, the programs will trickle out between now and sometime in January, as fast as I can get them edited. And without the advanced Kickstarter and all that stuff, I have less pressure to get them done real fast. So.
Okay. We'll see. That sounds good. We still appreciate it.
I'll get them done as fast as I can. You know, Chicago is where I grew up, so I've got some incentive to want to come home. I do have to buy one more camera. I think this shot here. Yeah, there's my current most expensive camera. That's about a $2,000 camera. The one that's sitting behind me is a $1,000 camera. I need one more of those. I need a total of four cameras, and I've got three. And I need to buy one more. So I'm going to be putting in an order for another $1,000 camera. I need something to shoot things at this level. I need cameras that are that good. So you got an idea sort of what my expenses are. My bank account is not super flush, but it'll stand doing this. So, freelance, non-ham radio stuff, freelance has been pretty good over the summer. So I've got a little more money to play with than I normally would. So I will see you, Steve Bible, in about a week and a half at the TAPR conference in Chicago. And you folks out there will get a chance to see it on Ham Radio Now if you don't see it in Chicago live and in person sometime starting in November, I would guess.
Okay, wonderful. Well, you have a safe trip, and we will look forward to seeing everyone in about a week and a half.
Okay, I'm going to let you get back to work, and I'm going to tell these folks a little bit more about the beach and stuff.
All right. Sounds good. Thanks, so, Gary. Take care.
See if I can push the hang up button. Bye-bye. Boom. Booyah. All right. So, yeah, that's the deal. I will be enjoying myself going out to Chicago and doing the recording the DCC as much on the cheap as I can. And the reason I need the four cameras is three of them will be unmanned. I won't be paying any camera people or even looking for any volunteers. Just three of them set up in different locations, unmanned. And I will stand all day long next to the one manned camera. I'm not going to be bringing the monster studio in a booth set up. Yeah, here it is all at the beach, the entire studio in a booth. Not going to be bringing that. It's also my editing system, at least my editing system on the road. So it'll be in the hotel room, but I won't be setting it up. I'll be recording on the cameras and little SD cards. I've got the micro cam here, but I don't have an SD card to show you, but they're about this big. Little SD cards. And that means I've got to spend a little more time editing, but it gives me more options because I've got the video from every camera, and I do a switch, a playback switch between the four cameras. And if I blow a switch, if I was doing it live, I'm stuck with it. If I blow it in the post-production switching, well, then I can go back and fix it. But it takes more time. So if you are interested in helping out, hamradionow.tv, and what have I got up here? The Patreon? Yeah. At hamradionow.tv, you will, let me switch over to hamradionow.tv, and you'll see Arvin here. Click Arvin. And this gives you the option to make a contribution through Patreon, or you can still do it through the good old PayPal thing at whatever level that you want. That's a one-time. Patreon is a monthly contribution, and the PayPal is a one-time contribution. I had a PayPal subscription thing going. Is this shot? No, that shot doesn't show anything. There we go. I had a PayPal subscription thing going for a while. Since Patreon is essentially the same thing, just turned off the PayPal subscription. Those of you that have PayPal subscriptions, it still continues to charge your bank account, your credit card, every month. But I won't take any new ones of those. If you want to do a monthly contribution to help support the program, it's going to be on the Patreon. Beach. What's the deal? Here we go. We sort of reversed the timing. Last year, the TAPR conference was... where am I here? Last year, the TAPR conference came before a beach vacation. This year, the TAPR conference is late. It's going to be in the middle of October instead of the middle of September. We moved our beach vacation up a little bit to the end of September, so this is coming before it. So, and I didn't set up any ham radio equipment here at the beach this year. My father-in-law, Mac, still has his station set up with the antenna up out on the deck. So this dipole and stuff that I set up, not done this year. Just totally ran out of time. Let me tell you what I'm doing. Well, first of all, if you want to see what's going on at the beach, go back to episode 166. It is all the same stuff. Nothing really different. This view here will be pretty much the same, the way I've got this set up, except over here I had the 756 Pro 3. And now it's just the audio mixer. I didn't have much time to play with it, and there was so much racket and noise coming from all the Wi-Fi and TV infrastructure here that I couldn't hear very well. I thought, okay, move my antenna out a little farther away, and that would help, but I just didn't have time. Okay, so here's why I didn't have time. I am in the middle, and this is why you haven't seen a Ham Radio Now program in a while, and now are not going to see another one for probably a month. You know, close the end of October. Maybe something will come up that'll allow me to stick one in, but as soon as I get back from the beach, I'm heading to Chicago. A couple days after getting back on the road to Chicago, and so I got to prep everything, get it ready, do the TAPR conference, and then get back here. And what I am working on that is keeping me from doing anything else is an edit for the DVD for the Navassa K1N operation. Now, you've seen the talk that they did for the K1N operation at Dayton. So that's here. Glenn Johnson and Bob Alphen both did pieces of that presentation. That's not what this is. This is the video that Bob Alphen, K4UEE, shot on the way there at the operation and a little bit on the way back. So much more extensive video coverage than they had for the Hamvention talk. The DVD will include the Hamvention talks, so it's going to have a lot of stuff on it. But it's got a lot more depth on what it took to actually execute the operation in a "you are there" all on video. None of it just somebody standing up there talking. Although you get that too from the Dayton talk. So that's what's coming up. It's going to be the K1N DVD, not just the Hamvention talk, and that's going to be pretty cool. But it is an intensive editing project. I've been working on it for a couple of weeks now, and I'm up to about 17 minutes worth, and the whole thing is going to be, for the main presentation, we're aiming at about 45 minutes, something that can be played at a club meeting without everybody getting all fidgety and wanting to get up and go to the bathroom and stuff. So that's the goal. And then that DVD will be for sale. Not through me, but through the K1N folks. Have I got their website up here? Yeah, there they are. I think they mentioned, oh, there we go. The K1N Navassa DVD is in process. And yes, I'm the guy that's holding up the process. If you want to know about it, stop by their website, NavassaDX.com. They'll let you know when it's ready. They're saying expecting in the fall. And that's my goal, to have it done shortly after I get back from the TAPR conference. And no more Ham Radio Now programs until that's done. Bob, I promise. Look at myself in the monitor. I need to look at the camera. Bob, I promise. Okay, that's it for this episode of Ham Radio Now from the beach. Did you enjoy this? I mean, really? Okay. Getting a lot of email and comments every place about the show. They come from all different directions. Too much not ham radio. Really enjoy the not ham radio. Too much talking and not getting to the point. And really enjoy the talking around and then eventually getting to the point. So, you know what the deal is? I need to do a show about this. But here we're at the tail end. I'm about to stick my hand in your wallet again. So I'll make my point here. I do the kind of show I want to do. I make the show that makes me happy doing the show. And if you don't like that kind of a show, you're welcome to tell me, but I'm not going to change. And if you like that kind of show, you're welcome to tell me, and I'll thank you very much. But that's the deal. I do the show that I want to do, not the show everybody wants me to do. I've spent my entire career doing things, making programs that somebody else wanted. And, you know, they would tell me what they wanted. I would tell them what I thought would work well. And sometimes they said, yes, that sounds like a great idea. You're a genius. And sometimes they said, thank you very much, Gary. No, do it the way we told you at first. And that's what I do, because that's what I was being paid to do. It's also being paid to tell them my best professional opinion of how things should be, but that didn't necessarily mean that's the way they were going to be. And you know what? Sometimes they were right. Often they were right. In fact, I tell the story about the best creative directors that I've worked with, where a producer crew, a writer crew, and I, as the video editor, would collaborate on putting together the first couple of versions of, it's mostly commercials that I've been working on. We would put something together, and then the big shot, the creative director, the guy at the ad agency that is being paid for his awesome creative input, would come in and watch it and usually tell us, yeah, that's pretty good, and then give us the list of things that he would like to see changed. And some of them were doable and some of them were not, and some of them were going to be a lot of work. And we'd tell him timetables and money and things like that. Timetables, my job. Money, someone else's job. And he would decide, or she would decide, what it was they really wanted to accomplish based on budgets and timetables. When I got done, almost invariably, it was better than what I could have done myself. So if you are an ad agency creative director and have really excellent chops in how to make programs and media better, I'll listen to you. But I'll still do what I want to do because you're not paying me to do this. All right. HamRadioNow.tv. See Arvin. I know that Arvin is on my left. I think I figured that out. There. Arvin sitting right under this hand. Yes, that's the way it works. There's Arvin. Click on Arvin. Stop by HamRadioNow.tv if you enjoy the programs. Whatever it's worth to you. Patreon is there for contributions of anywhere from $1 a month to whatever you want to put in. And PayPal is there for one-time contributions, and I thank you very much. Those of you that contribute, you are awesome. And that is it. I will see some of you in Chicago in a week and a half, and I will see many of the rest of you right here on YouTube or wherever you watch or listen to the program on Ham Radio Now. I'm Gary Pierce, KN4AQ 73, over and out to the beach. Who am I kidding? I'm sitting here editing in K1N, not getting out to the beach. I want to get out to the beach. It's just there on the other side of the Venetian blinds that are closed so that I can't see it. The beach is calling. Bob, I'm editing.